please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The next surah is Suratul Balad. This is Makkiya. This also is a Makki surah. And these are short surahs. Inshallah, sometimes if it's very short, we're going to do two or three surahs together. So, tafsir of Suratul Balad, which was revealed in Makkah, and here it talks about swearing. Here also many in the starting sanctity of swearing, the sanctity of Makkah and other things that man was created in hardship. And here Allah has sworn by Makkah, the mother of towns, addressing its resident during the non-sacred months. It's not a sacred month, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing. Free in this city in order to draw his attention to the significance of its sanctity when its people are in the state of sanctity. Was reported from Mujahid. So here it says hadith comes just for 1 hour or so. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said it's okay if you do jidal also, but then also Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't do it. You know that Makkah sanctity, still we have to take care of. We can't fight there, we can't kill people. Those are the things we have to take care of still after 1400 years ago. It's just not like 4 sacred months. No. All the whole year, 12 months. Even they have made that particular area, after that you can't enter. Everybody knows that non-Muslims, they can't enter. That is the sanctity of Makkah. But these days we heard like many things. They are starting new things, you know. But may Allah protect Makkah and all the sacred places over there. We can only make dua for that. La uqsimu bihazal balad. La, no. Uqsimu, I swear. Be with, by. Haza, this. Al balad, the city. This is the sacred city where Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was there for 13 years. And you know, he don't want to leave that city. But the persecution was so severe, he has to. He did the migration. So when you go there, you can see the city is different now. Like, and when you go Medina, you actually feel the, you know, presence and peace and tranquility of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because the end period was there. But when you come here to the Makkah, it's a different, it's like a honor and a different kind of feeling, you know, it's busy. So here talking about la uqsimu, la, no, uqsimu, I swear, be by, haza, this, al-balad, the city. I swear by the city of Makkah, where even to harm anyone is prohibited. Allah is swearing and saying, I am swearing this whole city is so sacred. Wa anta hillum bihaz al-balad. Wa, while. Here you might have noticed, here wa is not for and, it's for while. Sometimes wow is for and, for qasmiya, by, for sometimes, and by, while. Anta, you, hillum, one who resides, is lawful, bihaza, with this. Hill is like, you know, halal also, ha, lam, lam, same root word is for this. So one who resides is lawful. Al-balad, the land, city. So at least we'll try this 3 ayahs, you know, la uqsimu bihaza al-balad, wa anta hillum bihaza al-balad. Balad has been used twice. It means the land or the city. The city. Whenever al comes, it means the. And balad is city. And here particularly talking about Mecca. Uqsimu is from qasam. Qaf, seen, mau. Meme. And uqsimu, I swear. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This pronoun is towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa walidyum wa ma walad. And one who begets, gives birth, vama, and by what? Walad, the birth. I swear by your father, Adam al-Islam, and the children he begot, mankind, the whole mankind, because we are the children of Adam al-Islam. Laqad khalaqnal insana fi kabad. And we have created man to be in stressed. Laqad, certainly, khalaqna, we created, al-insan, the human, all the human being, fi kabad. Like a continuous struggle, they will be in struggle. In this, when you see, like, you know, when a child is born, that time also he's struggling to come out. It's not easy for mother as well as for the child. So same way, so this kabad is like a continuous struggle from the time we born till we die. We gonna be in kabad. A yahsabu, does he think allan yaqdira alayhi ahad, that did not he has power alay upon him anyone? Does he think that none has power over him? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking that man is thinking nobody has power over him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has power over us, because we don't know next moment what gonna happen. Allah knows everything. So we don't have yaqdira, any power, alayhi ahad, anyone. Not only we don't have power, not anyone else except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yaqulu ahlaktu malal lubada. It says, I have squandered wealth in abundance. Lubada is abundant, more he has given. Ayahsumu allam yarahu ahad. See, more and more time asking question. Yahsabu, do you think? You know, in that yara was there. Here, yahsabu is there. Alam naj yarahu was there. Here, yahsabu, do you think? Thinking, pondering, and you know, all this, we have to use intellect. We have to think about it. Because human being is which has given the intellect. The others has not given the intellect. Think about the animals. When we were created, what is the concern of angels? They said, oh, they're going to do fasad fil ard. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you don't know what I know. But before that, they say, nusabbi bihamdi rabbika. We're going to do tasbih and we're going to do all these things. Because they don't even realize what the human being is. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in that what human being is. Human being has been created and given intellect, and he was given asma. These are the names he memorized, and he was given the test, Adam al-Islam. So here, the human being is given so much importance. Yahsabu allam yarahu ahad. Does he think that no one observes him? Yahsabu allam yarahu ahad. No one observes, no one sees him. Have we not given him two eyes? Alam naj'al lahu aynayn. See, we have given two aynayn. So he asking, alam, do you not? See, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep on asking. When this surah starts, ayahsabu, then ayahsabu again, then alam, again asking, alam naj'al lahu aynayn, two eyes, wa lisanu wa shafatayn, and a tongue and two lips. This tongue and two lips, with this we talk. And before that, we with the eyes we are seeing. Without looking, it's so hard. When some people, they braille and they read it. When you see them, you will so thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given two eyes to see and look and read. This is a blessing. But this will be also asked on the day of judgment. What you did with your eyes? Have you seen this thing or any other thing which we are not allowed to? Which these days so much fitna is going on for the youngsters, for the teens, for the older people. Every age people is going through that, test. But we have to keep ourselves motivated. No, we have to go the straight path. And then when lisano shafatein, this, you know, tongue is so important. Whatever you say, it can be, you know, pleasing Allah or displeasing. So this is the thing, you have to control yourself. When we learn Tajweed teacher keep on saying, okay, first thing and then save with your tongue. That time we realize how much tongue we used to use, how much we have to lower the tongue, how much we should raise. Then we realize the tongue is so important. So same thing, when you are saying something, you are backbiting or you are saying bad things, like, you know, وَلِسَانُ وَشَفَتَيْن, you are using your lisan and shafatain, lips, in a bad manner. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is recognizing you with the human body, what it has. Before that, in Al-Fajr, we have seen the, you know, in the universe and how the things will be and the different sects of people we have seen. And then in that particularly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala focus miskeen and yateen. But now here, particularly talking about al-insan. Have you seen your tongue? Have you seen your eyes? This is how it is. And then it says, وَحَدَيْنَاهُ نَجْدَيْنَ. And here, وَحَدَيْنَاهُ نَجْدَيْن, then show him the two highways, good leading towards paradise and evil leading towards hell. Najdain, two ways. Which way we want to go? Here it talks about good and evil. So here, and shown him two ways, the good and the evil, similar to his, has been reported from Ali ibn Abbas, Mujahid, Ikrama, and Atta al-Khurasani, among others, similar to this ayah stated, verily we have created man from nutfa in order to try him. So we made him hear and see. Verily we showed him the way, whether he will be grateful or ungrateful. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about, you have been created with the water. But how you will be grateful? Whether you will do the things which please Allah or which displeases Allah. It doesn't mean some people, they take this in a wrong manner. Like pleasing Allah, they always please Allah by doing the self-ibadah. But what about the hukukul abd? About the slaves of Allah. We ignore that completely. We don't fulfill that. This is part of our religion. It's not like, you know, I'm doing five times prayer and I'm doing all those things, but I'm not fulfilling about the abd, what other people, especially like, you know, parents. But after marriage, our husband, our children, this goes on. The whole thing changes after the marriage. We are not focused on more on parents. Now we are more focused on husband. If we please husband and they'll take care of the children in a nice manner, Jannah will be yours. But you have to be in that manner. And all the other people, are we responsible for non-Muslim? Yes. We have to take care of the neighbor, whether we are going to school, be good to them. We are not saying like, you know, Namahram, we are talking and, you know, shaking the hands and being good. We are not talking about that. But at least be good to all the people, all the human beings, all the mankind. This is how it's going to be. And here, وَحَدَيْنَاهُ نَجْدَيْن, it can be, you know, anything which is difficult for you in this world. Every time you might have noticed there are two ways. You have to select this or that. Depends on you. But if your taqwa is good, you will select the right path. Sometimes you select wrong path, but you are restless. And you think, no, I did wrong, something wrong. Whether it is with the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or it's with the slave of Allah. And gradually you change your way and you come to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because this heart, this qalb, it has that restlessness. This is the sign of your iman. Iman lies in the heart. So, وَحَدَيْنَاهُ نَجْدَيْن فَلْتَحْمَ الْأَقَبَى. So he does not attempt to tackle the aqaba, steep path. It's a steep path. Wama adraka mal aqaba. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, what is aqaba? What will explain to you what aqaba is? It says, it is the freeing of a neck slave from bondage. Fakku raqaba. You know, freeing a slave. These days we don't see that, but it was like at that time. But these days we can help them, freeing the slave in that sense. أَوْ إِتَامٌ فِي يَوْمٍ زِي مَزْغَبَى. It's not only freeing from the bondage and giving of food in a day of famine. Here we have to understand this ayah number 14. أَوْ إِتَامٌ, like giving the food. فِي يَوْمٍ زِي مَزْغَبَى is like, you know, when you want that food. Actually, like sometimes, you know, I cook the food, I like that food and somebody came in. And I'm offering them. That sense, or somebody is very needy and they are very hungry and that time you are also hungry, but you are offering them. You understand what I mean? Sometimes it happens, you know, when we go Hajj or Umrah, that time we have only little water and we want to have our thirst, quench our thirst, and that moment of time somebody is asking, then we say, okay, awitaman fi yawman zi masqaba, okay, have it, because that's the hukum of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But it's on, like you are very sick, or that Allah knows your intention. But that's time, give food in a day of famine. You know, whether it's scarcity of the food or the whether you like the food and you're still sharing it. It can be anything. Yateem in Zaya Maqraba. Again the yateem. So we are talking about yateem in the previous surah and this surah. Inshallah, we're going to spend something. At least we're going to put some money in the masjid box. Inshallah. Or giving food in a day of famine and to an orphan relatives or to a needy in distress. Za maqraba is like, you know, yateem and za maqraba, you have to understand this. Yateem. Yateem can be anybody. But za maqraba is from qaraba, qafraba. It is from your blood relation. It's not talking about, in previous surah, we were talking about yateem, yes, miskeen, anyone. But here particularly, maqraba, it's from qaraba, it's from your blood relation. So don't be like, you know, oh, they are yateem, that's okay. No, you have to take care of them, yateeman. Aw miskeenam za maqraba, and the miskeen, they are in dust. And besides, he should be of those who believe. And you know, the here when talking about miskeen, matraba is like a, you know, having all the turab, dust. Have you noticed, yeah, miskeen people, just I mentioned before also, they have little money but not that much. So here turab is like, you know, not only dust, it means like, you know, they are going through so much they have on their face. That's the thing. And we think, oh, they are so dirty, you know, in hygiene, they can't maintain that kind of thing. We can, you know, tell them nicely, in a nice manner, okay, you have to wash your hand. This is the etiquettes we have to follow. We, instead of doing that, we make a distance and we started complaining. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us how it should be. Summa kana min allazina amanu wa tawasaw bis sabri wa tawasaw bil marhama. And those who, here he should be of those who believe, enjoin fortitude, encourage kindness and compassion. Here's, you know, the, how the Surah Asr is tawasu bil haqqi wa tawasu bil sabr. Here the same, it says, allazina amanu wa tawasu. Have that tawasu, enjoin, tell each other, bis sabr, with lot of sabr do that, wa tawasu and enjoin will marhama, it's like a mercy, compassion. You should have that compassion in your heart. If you don't have compassion, you won't be able to do anything. Ulaika ashabul maimana. This is the key part of the surah. Like how the irjil radia, same thing. Ulaika ashabul maimana. Such are the people of the right hand. Who are the right hand people? In Surah Waqia, it says, who are the right hand people? Right hand people are the people who are successful. And we want to be in the right hand. When the people, when we talk about the good deeds, we want in the right hand. We want to be successful. Inshallah, someday we'll do Surah Baqiyah. The whole detail has been mentioned in that. So here, Ulaika Ashabul Maimana is the successful people we are talking. We have good grades. We are happy and rejoicing. We want that report. Okay, good deeds. We want that. That's how it. Wallazina kafaru bi ayatina hum ashabul mash'ama. And the other people, kafaru, they denied, bi ayatina, our ayas. Look at the wordings of the Quran. You know, if I just read the translation, you won't be able to make that connection. So, wallazina, and those who kafaru, they denied, bi ayatina, with our ayas. Whom? These are the people, ashabul mash'ama, of the left side people. We never use this, like, until unless the filthy things, you know. Allah has given this hand also to recognize what is right and what is left. Okay? So the same thing, it's on, not only this right hand used for the right things. And this is the thing, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving the successful good deeds in right hand. And whenever we say good things, it's on right. Bad, left. So we want right to be more and more. And we don't want left. So these are the people, because they deny the ayat. They deny the ayah, and they are in the ashabul mash'ama. Alayhim narun musada. These are the people, left hand going towards hell, having fire all around them. Alayhim narun musada is like, you know, when you put the oven on 450 or set the temperature, and then you close the lid. It's like a musada, like enveloping and enclosing it, and that heat is, you know, more and more, you know. How it's going to be? That's how the narun, alayhim narun musada, is increasing the heat, and on top of it, it's closed. So that's how it is. So if we will see in one shot the whole surah, what it says. So here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about like sacred place, Makkah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has given the time, like, you know, if you want jidal, I can give you 1 hour or so. But he didn't. Here, importance of that place has been recognized, and also taking the oath of that place. And then what is that place? Then after that, talking about khalaqnal insana fi kabad, insan, like human being, has been created in struggle. It is continuous struggle, whether we are coming out from the mother's womb or whether we are spending the whole life, and whether we are going back. Even going back, sometimes we know some people are in sakrat, like mashallah, you both are doctors, you know, like the patients, when they are going through the stage of that, you know, the whole thing, how the sakrat will be so difficult. So we have to make dua Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, save us from arzilul umur, that age which we forget and do the things which we are not supposed to, and we very feeble, and when we are very weak, we have to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about, you know, how much maal you have given, and ayahsabu alam yarahu ahad, you know, keep on yahsabu, don't you think, you know, alam najhalu aynain, you have two eyes, and then, you know, lisan, shafatain, one hadainahu najdain, I have given the way out, hadainahu. And then what is aqaba? And then also talk about itamun, yomanzil mazqaba. When we want food, we are giving other people, and we are feeding them, and we are treating them nicely. When you want that food, so try to remember, when somebody comes in, we have nice food, try to offer them. I know it will be less for them. We can prepare another time. But same thing, if somebody is needy, and we give to them. Here, not talking about fuqara. It's talking about wa itamun yawman zi mazgaba, hunger. They have hunger, and they are like their tummy has been gone inside, you know, that kind of thing. Yateem in za maqraba, this yateem is from our blood relation. We have to take care of them. We have to look for such people. If they are in our family, we should help them. And then finally, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Allazina amanu wa tawasaw bis sabri wa tawasaw bil marhaba. You have to encourage each other. We have to do tawasaw with each other. And then the main core of the surah is Ulaika Ashabul Maimana. We want to be Ulaika Ashabul Maimana. At least memorize this ayah. Ulaika means those. Ashabu is from Sahib. You know, Sahib, Ashab. Yameen, Maimana is right hand. Ulaika Ashabul Maimana. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma inni asaluka Ashabul Maimana. This much small, try to memorize small duas, you know. And وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, we don't want to be kafaru, bi ayatina bi rabbihim, because we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And mashaba nalu narun alayhim musada, and the whole thing will be closed. May Allah save us all from such kind of punishment. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka.